I made some changes. I realized that it was taking up a bit of my willpower. You get to control your environment and how you are able to create what you want to see. I do still eat meat, but the thing is I can feel the effects of it.
When in fact, it glows beneath the H4 again.
The very nature of things, you cannot experience what is here. You can only experience the way it happens within you. Pain and pleasure happens within you. Joy and misery happens within you. Agony and ecstasy happens within you. Anything that ever happened to you will happen only within you. Right now, somebody next to you touches your hand, you think you're experiencing their hand. No. You are only experiencing the sensations in your hand. So, you are experiencing everything, whatever you have known, only within yourself. The very nature of things, you cannot experience what is here. You can only experience the way it happens within you. Or in other words, the fundamental seat of your experience is within you. If the entire human experience is being generated from within you, at least what happens from within you must happen the way you want it.
And welcome to today's second episode from this series of MonkMode. So today I want to go a bit more in details on what I have been doing. It's been about 17 days in, and of course I made some changes in my rules, and I also recommend you guys to, you know, be flexible with your rules, but make sure like the topic is still the same. For example, 15 minutes of meditation, I have just changed it into 30 to 35 minutes of the gateway experience. So this is something I've been pretty intrigued by recently. If you guys want to know more, just Google it. Apparently it's about, you know, syncing up both hemisphere of your brain by having different tones of sound. For example, if there's 410 hertz here and 400 hertz here, which is something that the brain, like our ears, can absorb, our brain would actually balance it out by making it just 10 hertz. And this is something that we usually are unable to hear unless we use this kind of hemisync technology. And I've been doing it for the past 2 days already, and I can tell that I do get really relaxed. It reminds me also of Vishan's Mind Valley Silva technique. It's quite similar. I think they use different way of explaining it, but it does get me to that state of like alpha meditation, or sometimes even deeper than that. So I do feel more relaxed than just the basic 15 minutes of meditation. So I think that this is something I still want to continue for the remaining of this MonkMode and potentially even outside of it. So for the book that I'm reading, I was actually reading Jordan Peterson's 12 Rules for Life. I started it, you know, during reading in the morning, but I realized that it was taking up a bit of my willpower. So in the morning, you know, your willpower is like a battery. So you start off at the highest peak and then it slowly decreases throughout the day, right? So when I put so much of my initial capital energy into reading, I find that after that, it's you know, not very helpful for the other stuff that I want to do that requires my attention. And since reading can be something that I do before bed, I've decided to do it at night. And because I'm doing it at night with no natural lighting, I started using my iPad. Right, so the book in my iPad is called Reality Transurfing. So Reality Transurfing and, you know, the Gateway Experience both have sort of the same message behind, which is you get to control your environment and how you are able to create what you want to see. So I kind of like this whole topic, going 21 days into this sort of spiritual journey as well as manifestational journey, right? So other than that, I feel that my second workout of the day is also quite tiring. So after the first set, right, where I was doing legs day and then I did running, I tried it again, I think 2 days ago, and I had to take a rest for 2 days. So other than those changes, I think the rest still remain the same. I'm eating mainly vegetarian diet and cutting down on meat. Even though sometimes, you know, you might still crave for meat, but just remember that you are eating someone else's trauma, right? I do still eat meat, but the thing is I can feel the effects of it. Okay, let me rephrase. Okay, sometimes I still crave for meat, but the thing is after I eat, like for example chicken, I do feel a bit more down. I'm not sure if I'm just overthinking it or I'm hypersensitive from all this meditation and stuff, but I'm at that point where I can see a bit more like rewards that are longer term than just the mouth feel, right? Delayed gratification in everything appears everywhere. So you might be instantly gratified by having some meat in your mouth. And then the effects comes after, when you're feeling like shit, feeling fearful, feeling trapped, feeling anxiety. These are exactly what animals are feeling when they are in the cage. So I'm not saying to cut out meat completely, because I do feel there are benefits in it. It's just, where is your meat from? And most of the time when you're living in a city, most likely it's coming from those very caged up areas, you know, they are trying to push profit instead of, you know, like balance things that cannot be measured with money, right? If you're just putting numbers on everything, it's just money in, money out, they will try to reduce the space, reduce the food, you know, feed things that are not exactly the best for the animals. But if you're eating some other cow who lived his whole life in the hills and just running around, and maybe raised by a farmer who really loves and named their cows and plays their music, then maybe it's something else. But so far, if you were to check out Dr. Emoto's research on water and how our feelings actually impact water, you would know that any living object, right, are mostly made out of water. So all this trauma, it carries within the animal itself. And like ourselves, if we are constantly talking down and not being supportive, we store that in our body. So I'm just gonna throw up some images, because I find this has been sort of like the pinnacle to why I am so sensitive when it comes to emotions, and why like my water bottle has like, you know, nice words attached on it. Like, this is something that comes with a wow, you know, you don't just immediately accept this as truth before implementing it, right? So I've been researching this for a while and now it's my truth. So hopefully this is, you know, the first time or maybe the seventh time before you actually decide that you want to do something with all these emotions. But hopefully it helps, because this is my learning lesson. Hi everyone, so I want to share a bit about something that I just learned, and I'm trying my best to explain it because I learn the most when I teach. Okay, so right now we're looking at Euro USD, and it's just market open, which is 8:30 a.m. in New York. What I can see is that price have already poked through the previous day's high, which is last Friday's high, twice.
So during our London session, if you know the power of three, which you could search up from ICT's videos, power of three is from market opening. There's the low that is created, and then it push higher to create a high, and then ultimately the closing. So this is what we call a Judas swing, because this is the Asian session. And then on the right, it's the London session that took out the low of the Asian range, the new week opening gap, the liquidity from last week, as well as tap on this hour one order block. And this is the exact same price as a 5 minutes fair value gap. The 5 minutes breaker if you were to go into the 5 minutes. So what I'm trying to share is right now, we have this hour four order block. That price have been poking through, but have yet not closed above this level. So even though the 1 hour, you can see that it closed above, on the hour four, which we'll see in 2 seconds, it's still not above this price with actual closing. So right now it's 8:30, right? And the next full candle for hour four is 9 p.m. So in about 20 plus minutes. And this is important because if you are currently in a long trade, so which means you're buying, which means you think that the price is going higher. For example, you entered over here, somewhere around here, and then your stop loss is here and you're planning to take the profit at maybe previous day high, 2 days previous day's high, last Thursday's high, okay? You might want to consider taking some profit over here, because if, now I'm going to go to the H4, if we were to still respect the order block that is this green candle's opening price, you can see that all these candles are still beneath it. If we were to respect this downward trend that you can see on H4, price is less likely to push higher during this closing price, because it still wants to print as respecting the selling pressure. But the thing is, when you're in a smaller time frame, you might go long, you might be against the larger trend, and that's okay. Just note that it's not something you want to do if the candle is closing. So another explanation that I put here is, it takes 4 1-hour candles to make 1 4-hour candle. Makes sense, right? So you could be buying in the H1, but if H4 respects its sell program, you should consider closing the trade before the hour is up. So I hope this is helpful for anyone who's trading. This is a bit more technical because it will come with experience. When you trade a bit longer, you will understand what I'm talking about. And we're trading time and price, so make sure to always check the time and then price. All right, good luck trading, and I'll see you guys in the next clip. All right, so now it's already 9 p.m. and the H4 candle has closed, as you can see. Just now, this candle was like a big green one that's all the way up. So people who were trading there would probably think that, oh my god, market is so bullish right now, I should continue, you know, holding my long position, when in fact it closed beneath the H4 again. So once again, we have a sell program during H4. So during the other 3 hours, you can happily buy your longs and in this market, but when it comes to H4, know that it's still beneath this order block. All right, I hope you learned something today. Please make sure to leave a like, and I'll see you guys in the next clip.